In northern Lebanon, next to the Syrian border, lies a remote village called Arsal. Arsal is surrounded by rugged and eroded landscapes with limited access to water. Until recently, people relied on agro-pastoral subsistence-based activities, but the community is seeking ways to gain entrance into modern Western economies, primarily through quarrying, stone cutting, and commercial fruit production. The impact these changes are having on local food traditions are profound, in that land-based food procurement is decreasing as families are relying more heavily on imported market foods, which are often less nutritious and are of poor quality. In Batloun, a village a mere 45 kilometers away from the Lebanese capital of Beirut, similar transitions are being experienced, but in many different ways. Here, people have abandoned agricultural-based activities and are becoming educated to acquire professional careers. Despite its rural location in the beautiful Shouf region of Lebanon, lifestyles are increasingly urbanized. The shift towards education and professional livelihoods has meant decreased interest in land-based food production and greater reliance on market foods for daily dietary intake. Like Arsal and other communities around the world, this move away from locally produced foods is contributing to poorer diets and increased levels of obesity and obesity-related diseases. What will follow, however, are glimpses into the resilience of certain cultural practices that point to the salience of local food traditions within the contemporary modern imaginary. Agriculture persists despite the harsh, unrelenting landscape. Here, within minutes of the centre of the town, and further up in the mountains where centuries-old ploughing techniques prevail, traditional agricultural methods are infused with modern methods and technologies, particularly those of irrigation. In this environment, people work the land for their daily sustenance and also for commercial production, particularly of fruits. In Batloun, agriculture has been replaced with family gardens, which still provide households with significant yields of fruit, vegetables, herbs, and spices. Households that can afford to irrigate have elaborate gardens and orchards. There is pride in the land and what the land produces. Making bread is an important traditional food practice in both Arsal and Batloun. Women prepare the dough, which is a laborious process. In Arsal, the tanur oven is often used to cook the bread. Bread is a staple source of food at each meal, thus requiring large quantities to be made each time. In Batloun, bread is typically made on a sarge. Here, women are making manouche, which is a favorite throughout Lebanon. From the land comes the food, which is at the heart of each household in Arsal and Batloun. Kidbi is a traditional dish that is either served raw or cooked. Lamb, beef, or in this particular case, chicken, can be used. In Arsal, food preparation typically takes place on the floor. Food preparation is an intergenerational activity which brings families together. Food presentation is an art form. In Batloun, more urban cooking practices are in place. Yet the dishes and ingredients maintain their traditional roots. Fresh fruit and vegetables picked from kitchen gardens are predominant in all meals. there is obvious pride in food, land, and culture.